talk about the benefits, please, of vegetarianism and veganism?
Okay, I'd be glad to start. First, we have to come up with an operational definition of what a vegetarian is and what veganism is. I don't consider myself to be either of those. I would assume that most people would call me a vegan, because my orientation is that I believe in a whole foods, plant-based diet, and which includes fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. That, I guess, technically fits into the category of being vegan. Vegan, in my understanding, is that you basically don't eat anything that has a face, and you don't eat anything that comes from a face. That means you don't eat dead birds, you don't eat dead animals, and you don't eat the excretions or products of excretions that come from animals. Animal excretions include eggs and milk, so basically dairy. Other people would stretch the definition of vegetarian into veganism, and it fits, it would be. But there are other categories of vegetarian that are not as restrictive. There's lacto-ovo vegetarians, for instance, who say that it's okay to eat meat and, not meat, it's okay to eat eggs, and it's okay to eat dairy products. They're okay with the excretions of animals. Chris, what's your understanding of vegetarian?
Well, you know, I agree with what you're saying, and I think our old definition of vegetarianism is not to eat anything that has a face. It's still applicable, but not so much as the evolution of thought of having a plant-based diet. I totally agree with Randy in that that is the way to go now, because vegetarian, vegan eating, vegan living is so akin to the healthiest lifestyle, the healthiest diet you can possibly have. It just makes sense to call it a plant-based diet. We can get all of our nutrients from plants. We can get all the protein anybody would ever need from plants. And we don't have to go after animals, dead animals or alive animals who have been tortured for eggs or for the dairy industry. So that's my idea of being a vegan. You want to share anything, Sean?
Well, I agree with you about the plant that's based on a plant-based diet. I eat eggs. I only eat organic free-range eggs that are also supplemented with an organic diet. I don't think just making a blanket statement that because you're vegetarian or vegan that you're healthier, because there's so many that aren't. Because they're eating all kinds of foods. They're not concerned with getting their nutrients. They've got a high starch diet. Processed foods still can be vegan, but they're not good for you.
Yeah, French fries and Coca-Cola are vegan.
Right, exactly. And so is white bleach flour and bromated flour and non-organic foods and stuff like that that are full of insecticides and you name it, you know. So that's the only thing that I say is a bad thing about, you know, saying that you're vegetarian or vegan. You know, you still need to get the healthiest foods, nutrient riches you can possibly get.
So there is
nutrition is only one part of why a lot of people choose to be vegetarians.
Right.
There are some people who have the environmental motivation to be vegetarian.
Right.
They don't want the factory farms that cause significant pollution. Mm-hmm. There are some who believe that factory farms are a primary, if not the primary, reason that we have an environmental crisis now. So there are, I would call them eco-vegetarians.
Right.
And also I would say that there are etho-vegetarians who choose to be vegetarians because it is unethical to be otherwise. You are torturing animals, you're developing them for the purposes of eating. I hear you when you talk about free range.
Mm-hmm.
But the problem with that, in my opinion, Sean, is that one of the from a nutritional perspective, is that especially in the United States, where we have a standard American diet, the vast, vast majority of people are getting way too much protein. Way too much protein.
Oh, yeah.
If you have a happy chicken who gives you an egg every other day, you know, I have much less problem with that. Mm-hmm. Especially if you feed him or feed her scraps from the table, where you're actually doing a form of recycling and you're using the manure from the chicken as a fertilizer. I'd give you that far, but that's about as far as I go into what I would call animal abuse.
Right.
That's as far as it would go. I can get that.
You know, I like, personally, I like chickens as a something to be used for pest control.
Yeah, very much, yeah.
You know, scratching in the dirt, picking up the bugs and stuff like that, that would be detrimental to my health or the health of the food I'm trying to produce. That's like our yard. We do not spray. The garden is 100% organic. We have turkeys that come from the park and other animals eat in our yard, but they won't go to our neighbor's yards because they spray them with all kinds of insecticide and vegicides and you name it. And there's nothing living in those yards, not even an earthworm.
Now, is there a tie from vegetarianism to the bigger idea of urban gardening that we've been discussing?
Absolutely. Yes. Sure, I could speak to that if you wish. You know, I think the whole vegetarian vegan movement is really concerned about, as Randy said, the environment, protecting animals, health. It encompasses so many different ways of life. Things that need to change now in 2018. And how we bring that together with urban gardening helps us look at the benefits of utilizing local manpower in creating our garden, in planting seeds that were saved, seeds that we know will yield good quality food, and bringing communities together, neighbors who can help with gardening and who can help in harvesting and tending to nutritious food. And there's where you get your vegan lifestyle is from, is establishment of these wonderful community gardens.
And that's part of what I would call econo-vegetarianism, where the economics of vegetarianism is is appropriate, I think, appropriate way to say it, because given how much it costs to buy food these days, if you're vegetarian and you grow a good portion of your own food, that's economic. It's also, if you look at your grocery bill, folks, the most expensive item on your grocery bill are the animals, the dead animals that you eat. If you grow your own organic food and you're not eating meat, you can get all the nutritional needs that you